All things said and done, one thing is for sure, that this industry is still tip of the iceberg. Again, I'm sorry, a lot of the things which I wrote in paper, everything all the people have said in the morning. But still, I'll try to put some new words. So, rightly said by Ritu, it is still the tip of iceberg. And again, a lot of entrepreneurs, businessmen, brands, equipments, everything has arrived in India. And one thing which is still arriving is, again, quality education, which is still a big barrier. But all things said and done, if I share my journey with all of you guys, which I think gives an example to correlate with the topic given to me, that how to scale up in the beauty industry and how to emerge as an entrepreneur, it's very simple. You have to develop your own people who love yourself, who love their work, who love the brand. If I look back 10 years back and how, if I see that being new to the industry, I met one very senior person in the industry 10 years back, before opening my first salon. I told him that I'll make 10 salons in 1 year. And he just laughed it out and told me, ki pehle ek chala ke dikhao. So that was, I think, people, again, sitting in the room might take it positively and negatively. And most of the people I met during that tenure, they took it very negatively, ki boss, ye mat karo, it is very tough. But I think that was the biggest motivation factor which drove me from there, that it is not 10, it is about something more. And it took 3 months to understand why that guy told me that itko chala ke dikhao. It was 10 years back, again, the biggest challenge was same, which is today. It is again a quality manpower. And apart from quality manpower, which I believe is the biggest mental block, rather from a taboo, rather from a caste or whatever, the people who are now joining the industry, whether they are dropouts, whether they are MBA, whether they are graduate. But it is an interesting part. Now we have people on the floor who are MBA even, because they are now connecting with this industry. But the one biggest challenge is that, you know, when a hairdresser and a therapist is interacting with a client throughout the day, one thing which is not changing and which is playing a big taboo in the growth everywhere is again, I think, his own ego. I don't know how many of you will agree with me. This is something is very common in the industry, whether they are therapist, whether they are salon owners for 30, 40 years. They believe humse badkar koi nahi hai. Whatever we think is the best. And I think this is one thing which from which I picked a lot of things from all those people only, that this industry has actually not evolved with the speed which it should have been. Just to quote an example, I think 20 to 25 years back, nobody wanted their daughter to go as an air hostess. But over the period of time, the industry has evolved. Everybody wants their daughter to become an air hostess or a crew member. And if I go a little more back, 60 years back, when in India there was no MBBS degree, people were talking about RMP. Every compounder was becoming a practitioner and doing the operation. But, and the sad part is, there are people in the UP still practice like that. But over the period of time, looking at the requirement, government has evolved the thing, degrees have come in. In this industry, all those things are still lacking. The recognition by Government of India, recognition by to the laws to be build the industry in franchisee. So all those are biggest challenges. But looking at this government in last 2 years, where certain good words have hit the normal consumer, but still, I don't know, everybody is saying ki achhe din kab aayenge. But still, the good words which has been put by Mr. Modi, Startup India, Digital India, Skill India, Make in India, I believe this is a good beginning which helps every entrepreneur, every startup to emerge as a big leader. So that is something which is evolving in this industry, that is from where we took this route. 10 years back when we started, from 1 salon to 9 salon, we took around 3-4 years. Fighting with all the manpower, education, and everything. Then we thought franchisee is one of the best route to evolve ourselves, to grow nationally, and to become one of the biggest in India. And then that is from where we started. Now again, the biggest challenge becomes how we do it. To run your own shop, to run your one business is always very easy. And I think everybody who is running his own shop, he works with heart. He opens the shop at 9 o'clock in the morning. He closes the shop at 10 o'clock in the morning whenever there is a customer and everything. Now, the biggest challenge when you spread wings is that to induce that quality in your team, to induce that quality in your franchisee. Long time back when I started learning franchisee, I read somewhere in USA that franchisee means a business manager for a company after putting in the money. That is how USA people define a franchisee. That somebody who invests for you and then somebody who works for you. Down the line, it is very successful there, probably because of the government rules, legal ways, and the, I would say, exposure people which have. People associate with their business, don't put their ego between it. The biggest challenge which I feel in Indian market, when people become a franchisee, after 3 months or 6 months, they think we know everything, and now we don't require a franchisor. And that is where the difference of opinion starts. And when we started 6 years back, one of my colleagues asked that, you know, how you will retain these people once you got them on a board? I told them one thing very clearly. Again, all my seniors have said same thing in the morning. It is all about being innovation. It is all about being putting something new all the time. If today we recruit somebody on board as a franchisee, and if he has something to always to look up to us, so he will be always around. That is what I think. At the same time, it is all about, I tell my team all the time that if you have to emerge as an entrepreneur, if you have to emerge as a brand, even as an individual, it is all about connecting with the people. The only thing which makes you bigger is your team. Brand is all about team. I hope everyone agrees. So it is all about connecting with the people, whether they are employee, whether they are franchisee, whether they are your vendors, whether they are whosoever who is connecting in your ecosystem. It is all about connecting with them. So we in last 10 years, we did a lot of new innovations every year. I have a lot of negative feedbacks for me as a person also during this all 10 years journey. But I think all those negative feedbacks have been a driving force to reach on a bigger platform. And I think that has already helped me in a big way, that I'm today here talking in front of people who were actually truly inspirational, true inspiration when we started this business. So coming back to the point, how we can increase the entrepreneurship through franchisee, I believe having a system in place. I still remember last year speaking in Salon Congress, we were talking how to retain the franchisee. It is all about having proper SOPs. Somebody asked in the morning about education also, that I think all the big people who are managing, all the big brands who are managing number of salons. It is all about creating good SOPs. And as a franchisor, we believe that those SOPs has to be, you know, has to be evolved in the ecosystem in such a way that everybody follows that. And that is the most important key point, that if the system is being followed and everybody puts their heart and soul into the business, whether it is a franchisee or it is your staff, the business will have a very big kickoff start. The biggest challenge is people don't put their heart in the business. And then somewhere down there's a mental block, then we sit, we resolve, then we take it further. So that is what all has been happening in this, you know, all those years. Again, when we thought to associate with Franchise India for this show also, that was also a big challenge, whether we should go there in a big association or not. So there were always positives and negatives has been discussed within in the office also. But I believe all things said and done, it has been a wonderful decision, because somebody has to take the lead to evolve the industry. After a certain time, I believe every entrepreneur feels it is time to give back to the industry. So thinking that all the people sitting in this room are all the people from industry, why I should talk about how to run the business? I think, no, it is not like that. I wanted to share my journey with all the people to give them an opportunity that, you know, it is very easy to grow. It is all about, very, very rightly said by Mr. Kumarabel, it is all about, you know, putting your idea into your all, into the, how do we implement all the things. Having an idea, then implementing into it gives the money. 10 years back when we started, the biggest, 10 years back, the thing which was luxury in salon system, whether it is interior, whether it is quality brand, whether it is quality manpower, all those things are nowadays the bare necessity. The market has evolved so much, and still it is a tip of iceberg. That is where the big opportunity is. When we started 10 years back, I still remember talking to one of the senior members of L'Oreal. 2007, I told him, buddy, I will launch Panipat. And he comes and tells me, are you out of your mind? Why Panipat? I said, this is the market where the business is. And believe me, that was my first franchisee when I started with Panipat. And that is where from we got a kickstart, that two-tier towns, three-tier towns. That is how everybody has the money. Everybody wants to become a Shah Rukh Khan. Everybody wants to, you know, have the latest fashion. It is that we have to be there to deliver them. That was the whole ideology from where we started. And that is something which I tell my whole team to teach the franchisee, that, you know, it is all about connecting with the team and giving them the latest. All the new ideas has to reach to the client at the earliest so that they connect with you, and giving them, and then giving them an assurance that, you know, whatever latest is in there in the industry, we will bring to them so that they are always, they always see something innovative happening. And at the same time, I don't tell any franchisee that, you know, you can't do it. I always tell them that if I can do it, you can also do it. I think that is something which actually induces the entrepreneurship in the every franchisee. Today, if we want to scale up through franchise business, the idea is to scale up the entrepreneurship into the franchisee. He should not do one salon with me. He should do 10 salons with me. Only then brand will get bigger. That is a message which today I want to give you from all this, from this stage, that everybody who is working with you has to have a zeal to become bigger with you. Not with you, first he has to have a zeal to become bigger. Then it becomes our responsibility to you know, make him ensure that he grows bigger with us. And that will happen with the perfect system, the perfect ecosystem in place, the perfect motivation in place.